Hello again and welcome to Suds and Country Video. Hi, I'm Herb Suds, and on this very special edition of Suds and Country Video, I have the pleasure of having Highway 101 surround me.
Hello,
how are you doing? Buddy.
What we're going to do is pass this handheld around to everybody as we talk, okay?
Sure.
How did the band get their name, Paulette?
Well, it was just a name that sounded good to us, and actually, there's a Highway 101 where the guys are from in California, and there's one in Minnesota where I'm from. So we figured, good name for a band. Connecting link between us.
Connecting link. And like it says here on the bio, a lot of different musical roads have come together to create the pure, appealing country music of Highway 101. The collective career histories of promising young bands spanned a wide creative, stylistic, even geographical range. Is that all true?
I don't know. That sounded pretty nice.
Pretty
geographically
nice.
Eclectic,
cool. Creative, stylistic, and geographical.
I tell you, what you guys come up with is amazing.
Cool.
Did you write that?
Well, I do a lot of the bio work. Yeah, you can tell that the way it's worded is you know, collective and eclectic and no, geographic, and there's a lot of those words.
Eclectic. Would that be words? The words for your glass? We do this all the time.
There's a lot of words I use in there, and there's a lot of things, a lot of my thoughts, a lot of my heart and soul is in this first paragraph here. Mm-hmm. So if you keep that in there, I'd really appreciate
it. It's not the part that I crossed out, is it?
No, I think eclectic, is that the word for those glasses there? Cactus really doesn't wear glasses.
No, the word for these is optic. It's optic.
But you don't wear glasses.
Today?
Well, I do time, ma'am, tonight, so obviously I do.
Paulette has been compared to Emmy Lou Harris. I read that somewhere.
Oh, really?
Is that true?
I don't know. You tell me.
I don't know. I read it somewhere, and I figured
Well, Miss Emmy Lou, she's a wonderful singer, very nice lady, and so that's a compliment.
I think they both have appendectomies, is why.
I've never had an appendectomy. Picked a hard one. Nor have I had my tonsils removed.
Is your music considered country rock? Did that word still exist today?
Of course it exists.
I think it's been reborn, actually. It was kind of a dirty word for a little while in the music business, I think, because it was kind of a style that had no home. It didn't really have a radio audience or anything. And now I think that due to the broadening growth of country music, it's maybe a term that can be used again and actually have meaning.
What's the difference between country rock and contemporary country and progressive country?
Curtis would know that.
Curtis? You're on, pal.
Could I hear the question one more time? The difference between contemporary rock?
What's the difference between country rock, contemporary country, and progressive country?
Very little, to be honest with you. I think that country as it is today is sort of a conglomeration of all three of those things. I think contemporary country was always kind of like... they're all synonymous, if you want my opinion. I think it's all kind of saying the same thing in different snappy terms. Kind of, it sounds like Cactus might have made up that phrase.
Those are a lot of my words.
Well, you got off the hook easy that time.
Shove it over to Cactus, that's all. I read a clip in another magazine that said, "You sound like you mean it when you play." What's that mean?
Boy. You read a lot of magazines. You got a lot of quotes here.
You need to start out more, buddy. You need to start getting out.
I shouldn't read as much as I
I think it's wonderful. What was the question again?
I read a clip in a magazine.
That we mean
saying,
what we play?
You mean what you play.
Of course we do. Well, that's very nice. We are sincere about our music. And that's very nice to hear.
I think that's one of the... whatever sort of success we've had, I think, is that's... one of the reasons we've had the success that we've had is because I think it's obvious on the tracks and in our shows and things that we're sort of doing what comes naturally.
There's very little covering up in the studio either. I mean, it's a pretty honest sound, I think, on the record. A lot of people comment that they can feel an energy and they know our sound even before anybody starts singing. And I think it's just we don't put strings on stuff and cover up with lots of keyboards and stuff, so it's pretty honest.
What makes Highway 101 sound so distinctive, Jack?
Well, I think Cactus just about said that. And we're all real thankful to our producers for that. They help us in the respect that when we play what we play, they say go for it. You know, instead of trying to play safe, so we just play kind of with an attitude, and that may contribute to whatever our sound is.
The attitude they went, yeah.
Okay.
That really did, Jack.
Sounded impressive to me.
Yeah.
I didn't follow it after the first.
I lost it after the first.
I like to play with the attitude. Does that mean that you went to bed late and you got up real morning and you're kind of feeling rough and tough and you just kind of... We got a song on the new album. It's called Rough and Tumble Heart. We love it. We hope everybody likes it. No, it was written by Pam Tillis and... And was it Bob DePiro?
Bob DePiro.
Bobby D. from Nashville.
Is it easier to play standard country tunes, or is it easier to play your own music when you're on stage in front of a live audience? You're playing a lot of music from somebody else that other people write. Is it easier to play that?
Well, it feels like our own music. For example, Whiskey, If You Were a Woman. I mean, that's our music.
Yes.
You know, whether somebody else wrote it or not, it's ours to a degree, you know. We formed the instrumentation
you
on it.
You ever play music from that somebody else?
Track?
A song that somebody else had to hit on, and you bring it back.
We haven't.
Yeah. Sure. Like Buck Owens. I think I read where you played a Buck Owens tune.
Yeah, we did. I don't know if that was a big hit or not, but we do songs by other people, and it's like wearing clothes. You know, I mean, you can wear clothes that you made, or you can wear clothes that somebody else made. But if it's you put it on, and it. That's the way it feels.
Right.
So it doesn't really matter whether you write a song or not if it feels like it's you.
When you
is it okay if I use this clothes thing in my next bit for our bio?
Like wearing clothes.
That was another good one.
It's like wearing clothes, right?
Yeah, just like wearing clothes.
I went shopping today, didn't find a thing. Speaking of clothes.
How big was your first album?
How big? How big.
Yeah. How many hits came off that album?
Four.
Four. Mm-hmm. Number ones?
Our first single went to number four, Whiskey went to two, and then Cry, 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 and Somewhere Tonight went number one.
Number one. Name some awards that Highway 101 has had so far.
My mother gave me Daughter of the Year.
Oh, that's great.
She hasn't spent much time at home this year.
No, actually, we won CMA last year, and...
ACM, Vocal Group of the Year twice in a row. Mm-hmm. And what else?
We just won Radio and Records Group of the Year just a week ago or something like
nominations?
That.
Nominations? What were you? I saw you nominated when I was in Nashville for something. What was your award?
No, TNN. And we're nominated right now for the Music City Awards Group of the Year, and there's a few of them. We won the Jukebox Association New Group of the Year last year. We won International Group of the Year from an awards in England.
We just won an award, guys, that you haven't heard of, one from Minnesota.
I read that.
Country Group of the Year.
You were, what did I say, right here, eventually landing Minnesota's Female Country Vocalist of the Year Award.
Oh, that was before I moved to Nashville.
I know, but
that was a
long time ago. Yeah, but I was just reading that in a bio a while back. I was just here browsing
through
your
book. You read a lot.
How's 101.2 doing?
It's doing real well.
Mm-hmm. You had a number one hit off that so far?
Yeah, like Hector said, Just Say Yes. Do You Love Me? Just Say
and
Yes.
And how about Honky Tonk Heart is doing good so far?
Well, it's going to be shipped in about a week.
Let me ask you, have a video out
the duet did real
heart.
Well.
You have a Honky Tonk Heart video coming out.
We just finished it.
Do videos sell records?
I think they do. What do you guys think?
Well, that's probably a matter of opinion. I think videos are mostly like a vehicle for the audience to get to know the artist a little bit better. Whether they sell records or not is hard to say, except we did a video on Cry, 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 and we sold like twice as many albums during the period that was out. Whether that's a coincidence or not, it remains to be seen. But... we'll see. Honky Tonk Heart was our first video off the second album, and if that does well, then I think we might have proven a little something.
Proven the theory there. I mean, there's a lot of arguments on both sides.
I've never asked that question to anybody I interviewed, but I just happen to think
it's not really a good question.
I shouldn't ask that question anymore is what you're telling me. How did you feel about being part of the World of Circle being broken too? I saw your name there and I played the song.
Well, I thought it was real nice that they asked me to do that.
An honor, I imagine.
Yes, it was. It really was. And they're going to have a show at Red Rocks. I think it's June 22nd or 23rd, somewhere around that time period. And I'm going to fly out and do the show with all the other guest artists.
How was it to work with the Nitty Gritty Dirt Band and all those heavyweights that were on that album?
They were real fun to work with. They liked to kid a lot, and they gave me no slack.
No slack at all.
No. Michael Martin Murphy was there. I think he is so cute.
Oh, yeah.
But he's got a nice wife. And I have a nice boyfriend, but he is so cute.
And I have two nice dogs and a couple of nice dogs.
And a nice wife.
And a great wife.
In the group's travels, where is Highway 101 most received? Best received in there with the music?
Oh boy,
it's pretty well received all over. I mean, we've played in front of different audiences, like Randy Travis's kind of crowds. I mean, we've been out with different artists, as Hank Jr., which is more rowdy, and they're real. It's a lot of fun. I mean, it's been great since we first started going out on the road. As they start recognizing the tunes, as they've grown to know us a little bit, it's been good to see them sing along with the songs, and so we're pretty well received. I mean, I haven't had anything thrown at us yet.
Okay.
Don't get any ideas. Just take the tomatoes out of the cans, that's all.
I was doing some reading, and everybody's played a lot before they joined Highway 101. Who was your idol in the music business?
My idol? Boy, I don't know. Idol's kind of a weird term. I've respected a lot of players. Merle Travis was probably one of the first guitar players. Merle Travis, Chet Atkins, then it went on to Don Rich and Roy Nichols and guys like that, but in the country field, because that's where I grew
basically
up.
Guitar players.
Well, I mean, for guitar playing,
right, yeah.
But there were a lot of singers, you know, like Lefty Frizzell, Haggard, and guys like that. Ray Price, I loved, you know, so. Then I branched out and got into rock and roll.
Did you play in rock bands before Highway?
One. I played with Burton Cummings for a while from the Guess Who.
Here it is.
Yeah,
I read that.
Right there it is. You read it.
I'm doing great. I can spot all this on the bios right away. Paulette, who was your idol?
Well, I don't know. My mother, I don't know. I didn't have any really idols. I can mention a lot of people who sing and I really like and things like that. I think Barbara Streisand's a great singer.
Okay. My idol, John Wayne, I suppose.
Okay. Curtis?
John Wayne was an excellent drummer, I always thought. John was a good drummer. I don't know. I would probably have to say the first thing, as far as like an idol, I think that the first things that really excited me about being an entertainer in some fashion or another would probably have to be like the Beatles or Elvis or Debbie Gibson. I don't know. I can't figure out which one.
That's my idol, Debbie Gibson.
How did it feel, your first song, the song you wrote, "The Bed You Made for Me," being a super, super hit that it was, the group's first song out? How did it feel?
It felt wonderful, because for years, the producers, publishers, writers in Nashville had been saying to me, "That's a hit song. That'll break a new artist."
How long was that song around before you broke it and made a...
7 years.
Was it? You wrote that 7 years earlier?
Yeah, about 6 years. I wrote it when I first moved to Nashville. So it had been about 6 years.
Well, must be an incredible feeling to go and record your own music and
it was the first song to be a smash.
It was real special for me. We were talking down in the lunchroom earlier.
I was getting my cake and
I
milk.
I know, you're getting dinner. What did you wind up with, carrot cake?
Carrot cake and milk, and it was very good.
Was it?
Yes.
Well, do you think the band will be remembered by that song? What song so far, out of all the songs you've had, that you'll be remembered the most far in your career up to date?
I'd like to think The Bed will be one we're remembered by. I think Whiskey is a very strong one.
You agree, sir?
I agree, certainly.
You agree?
He never.
You agree?
I'll disagree. I agree. There's a lot. I mean, the more a band plays, the more of a repertoire that people get to know. Sure.
I want to thank Highway 101 for being my guest on this show. It's an incredible feeling.
Yeah,
you know.
Thank you very much,
Jack Paulette. It's been a pleasure.
Buddy,
sir, I've met you a couple times.
It's true.
Curtis, it's been a pleasure.